Hey guys, here's a question for you. What do you think would happen if a young boy met a tiger? Well, if your answer to that question is, it was nice knowing you, kid, then sadly today's movie is not for you. This is A Tiger's Tale. By the way, can we please stop using the word tail like this in the titles of animal-based kids' movies? It was cute when Don Bluth did it, but now it's just getting old. After the opening titles are done showing us some antics with the titular tiger using some of the worst 2D animation you'll ever see in your life, because we all know that halfway decent animators are just impossible to come by.
But in the end, time is going to crush
you. Our movie opens in Safari World, and we're being led through it by our narrator who talks like he's involved with the story in some way, but we'll never actually see him. Thanks a lot, movie. I just love having Agent Fox flashbacks.
It's here at Joe Camp Safari World and Animal Rescue Park that our hero, Billy Connolly, begins his adventure. Let's meet some of the friends here at the park. Our story could be about this cool guy, Digger, but that might get a little too dangerous.
Yes, crocodiles are just a little too dangerous. Not at all like tigers.
Here's my good friend, Gray.
Just as long as it isn't Stinky or Runt.
Mr. Tubbs. He's really old.
They call him Mr. Tubbs.
Rainbow. Isn't she beautiful? But our tale isn't about her either.
I just thought that it would be fun to waste everybody's time. I mean, hey, anything to pad this movie out and keep your kids quiet for a while, am I right?
Hey, Dad, look.
And this is Billy, the boy I mentioned earlier.
Wait, hang on. That's supposed to be Billy Connolly? Looks nothing like the guy!
And these are Billy's mom and dad, Cheryl and Michael.
Oh my god, is the entire movie gonna be told like this?! This is the unexpected plot twist that gets our first act started. This is B-roll. It's footage that isn't vital to the plot, but it helps paint a picture of where we are. This is the end of the movie. Is it your favorite scene too? I knew it would be. Yeah, by the way, this movie was released in 2014. Who still uses Polaroids these days? Anyway, we're introduced to not Billy Connolly and his friends Doreen and Kobe, as Billy very awkwardly tries to hit on Doreen.
So, Doreen, what are you doing here?
I just came to see the tigers. I just love them. How about you?
Oh yeah, I love them too. The bigger the better.
So, you came with your parents?
No. I came alone.
Really? Isn't that your mom and dad over there?
Hi. Yeah, that's them, all right. But I was alone earlier, you know.
Well, not alone. I was with you.
No, you were with me. Before, I was with you. In between the time I left my parents and Kobe appeared, I was alone.
Glad we got that straightened out.
Not a good sign when the director doesn't know what to do with the scene, so he just throws a tiger at us to make up for it.
Maybe she'll come over if we give her a piece of the dog, or maybe all of it.
Kobe, I don't think that's what
you... Whoa. Do not put your hand in that cage. You may not get it back.
Thank you, Christopher Judge from Stargate. Much cheaper and easier to hire you to tell kids to keep their distance instead of just installing a safety railing to keep people away from the fence. We then meet these two twerps, who I guess are supposed to be a couple of bullies, who torment our hero by putting a hot dog into his backpack and throwing it onto the ground. And instead of... you know, immediately getting his backpack, Billy leaves it there for long enough for some zoo employee to go into the cage to clean it, leave the front gate open, and let Luna the tiger cub escape into the backpack. It should also be noted that Safari World seems to be suffering through some financial problems right now. The movie doesn't explain why exactly, but I would imagine that their animals escaping several times a week and maiming and killing people would have something to do with that. By the way, not only does this employee gain access to the tiger cage from where the guests are walking around, but I'm pretty sure the cage doesn't even have a lock on it. Safari World really needs to rethink their $20 security budget. But then again, I don't see how this zoo is supposed to make any money, since Billy's mom picking him up from the street seems to indicate that this place doesn't even have a fence or a ticket booth or anything. Billy's dad grabs his backpack, since Billy himself couldn't be bothered to, and I guess Luna somehow zipped herself inside, or else why the hell isn't she scrambling to escape? Billy soon discovers that there's a freaking tiger in their car, but his parents don't believe him.
did what?
There's a tiger in the back of the car, Dad!
Oh,
Dad.
No, not that again. All day he's been talking about bringing home a tiger.
Bringing home a tiger?
Okay, I think he said once that he wanted to bring home a tiger, and I'm pretty sure that it was only a joke.
Oh, cool. Can I get one of those?
One of what?
Those what?
When a kid starts panicking about how there's a tiger in the car, I think you can afford to humor the kid and at least take a look. Since his parents aren't listening to him, it's up to Billy to get Luna back to Safari World himself. But instead of figuring out how he can take her back right away, all he can think about is how he'd be the coolest kid in school if he actually kept her. Yeah, never mind how she's tearing up your stuff and causing all kinds of havoc, you need to carry around this wild animal as a status symbol.
You know, your family may have come from India. Huh, it also says that you're the biggest type of cat in the world.
I looked up that information by doing an image search. Wait, what? Oh yeah, and Luna's family may have come from India? Here's another newsflash for you. I think Billy's grandparents may have come from the same family.
Spot on! Believe in it!
Yeah, there it is! Headbanging, it's a headbanging detergent.
After they have dinner, where Billy almost blurts out that he's got a tiger in his room, he brings a bowl of milk to Luna, where his dad almost sees for himself that he's got a tiger in his room. And of course, he doesn't find it strange at all that his son was just drinking out of a bowl of milk on the floor.
So mommy tells me that you're interested in girls now. I just want to know, you know, do you know about the birds and the bees?
I know a lot about baby tigers.
Hell no. This movie has been painful enough already. I am not going to sit through this movie's awkward interpretation of the talk. Next scene. We then cut to something that, of course, must be less unsettling than that, which is Billy and Luna sleeping together with the romantic pop song playing in the background. His dad just finished trying to tell him how sex works, and now we see him sleeping with a tiger. Is it just me, or are kids' movies getting really creepy? Oh, get this. It should be pretty clear by this point that this movie wants to establish an unbreakable bond between Billy and Luna, right? But instead of trying to illustrate their growing relationship, we're seeing flashbacks of Luna and her mother. She clearly doesn't want to be with this kid. Actually, now that I think about it, is this a flashback, or is this just her imagination? They're frolicking in a field in this footage, but Safari World doesn't look like it has any big open fields like this. Is she just imagining this field? How could she imagine it if she was born in captivity in a place where she wouldn't even know what grass is? Well, whatever this footage is supposed to be, how are we supposed to be cheering for Billy and Luna's friendship when it's obvious that all she wants to do is go home? We get some hijinks the next morning, where of course Billy has to hide Luna from his mom, but all I can think of is why his mom doesn't immediately notice how her son's room smells like tiger piss.
I only wish Howard Johnson was buying a house for me.
Stop it!
Stop what?
Stop worrying about the people who you aren't selling to and start worrying about the people who you are selling to. Believe in yourself.
You know what? You are absolutely right. All this negative energy is ruining business. Just focus on the positive. Believe in myself. You're a pretty smart kid, you know that?
Not really. You're just remarkably stupid by comparison. We then get this completely pointless scene of Kobe being a fat loser because he's the fat kid, and a fat loser is all he can ever hope to be. Thanks, movie. And the bullies are getting the whole thing on video.
This is definitely going on America's Stupidest Home Videos.
Because America's Stupidest Home Videos is totally something that kids from 2014 talk about, right? Speaking of, you'll usually see a movie talk about something fictional as a placeholder for something well-known in the real world, like, in this case, America's Stupidest Home Videos instead of America's Funniest Home Videos. They usually do this to avoid copyright infringements, but since this movie is already ballsy enough to show Frosted Flakes and Sprint, why wouldn't these kids talk about putting their video up on YouTube or Facebook? Wait, why am I questioning where these kids want to post it? I should be asking why they're even getting it on video in the first place! He's slipping and sliding on a slip and slide! That's what it was designed to do! But hey, if you think that that's something, take a look at this. I can take this Lego brick and connect it to another Lego brick. Isn't that just wild? Billy gets Kobe to help him take Luna back, but first he has to swear to secrecy that he won't tell anyone.
Just swear it.
Okay. I swear that I'll tell everybody nothing.
Don't tell anyone anything.
I'll tell nobody everything.
Don't tell nobody nothing.
Right, so nothing about everything. I'll tell no one?
No, Kobe. You do not tell anyone about anything that happens here today.
But what if they ask?
You know nothing.
Oh, for God's sakes. The guy who's on first base is named who? Next scene! We jump back to Safari World, and they've locked their not doors until Luna can be found. And they think that the best thing to do to get her back is to just stand around and hope that Luna will return somehow. Way to be proactive, guys.
Hi, just keep getting the same message from Safari World.
Why are you texting them instead of calling them? If they have operators that are there specifically to text back any question that anybody might have, why don't you just call them and tell them that you have their tiger? But since no one at Safari World is picking up, seriously? The kids decide to go there themselves to tell them that they have Luna. Why not just take Luna there in your backpack?
Because if the feds catch us, then we'll be locked up in juvie for like 10 years. We won't get out till we're like 21.
Well, okay, in the real world, that would be something to worry about, but considering how everyone else in this movie is as dumb as a sack of hammers, I'd bet you could tell them that it's just a puppy and they'd believe you. Anyway, if they need to keep Luna from destroying the house while they're gone, so they do the most humane thing possible and keep her cramped up in a tiny box. But it's not all that terrible, since these kids are freaking stupid, and they didn't bother securing the trunk or even closing the door properly. Hey, guess what? The tiger gets out and she makes a mess. Oh, my mistake. She gets out and makes a mess while ripping off the soundtrack from Pee-wee's Big Adventure. I don't know, let me shade my eyes from the sun that isn't in front of me so I can see. They bump into Doreen and two of her girlfriends in the park, all three of whom are probably texting each other right now, and Kobe immediately spills the beans about Billy having a tiger after he just swore to secrecy!
We don't know anything about anything, remember? You promised!
Did that include the baby tiger?
He swore you to secrecy because of the baby tiger! Is there any part of your brain that actually works? And of course, the bullies show up. Okay, I can see this guy being a problem for Billy, but why the hell is he so scared of this little dickweed? He's a foot shorter than Billy, he's got no muscle mass. You could just try to walk past him and you might find him on the bottom of your shoe.
How about a noogie sandwich?
No, stop it!
Okay, to be fair, seeing a couple of kids whipping out their cell phones to record another couple of kids getting beaten up by some bullies instead of trying to help them out is actually both pretty funny and poignant.
I think I'm gonna post it on YouTube.
And you just had to go and ruin that completely. Thanks, movie! Okay, so we do live in a world where YouTube exists. Why would these girls post their video on YouTube while the bullies wanted to send their video to America's Stupidest Home Videos? And of course, Kobe has to blab about the tiger to the bullies, too.
If you have a tiger, then where is it?
In a very safe place?
Very safe.
Then we'll settle this tomorrow. You meet me at 3 o'clock. You show with no tiger, then you're gonna get a beating and go down in history as the biggest liars of all time. You got me?
Who are you?! But yeah, Billy and Kobe agree to meet them tomorrow with the tiger, and they go straight home instead of going to Safari World, which was the entire point of them leaving the house in the first place! And surprise, surprise, the house is completely thrashed. Except for Billy's room. Huh. Billy gives Luna over to Kobe, and he takes her to his place where he'll probably do a live stream to show her off to the entire world, or he'll forget that he's not supposed to eat her. Billy's mom shows up before they can clean the mess up, and she is not at all happy.
Billy!
Oh my, what happened?
happened?
Look, I can explain.
What do you mean? You did this?
What? No, I was out with Kobe all day.
Well, then who is responsible?
The Buster did it.
Wow. I literally hate everything about you now. No, I'm not kidding. It would be too easy to blame this mess on a burglar or something, but nope. He has to turn his dog, man's best friend, into a scapegoat. You are scum.
Hi, Ian. We've been robbed.
Oh no, didn't you hear? It was Buster who did it. It's the only possible explanation of what happened. I hope that tiger rips your lying face off.
If Mom and Dad found out that I have a tiger, I'd be in so much trouble. Go to jail.
You weren't worried about going to jail when you were telling your parents about the tiger the first time you saw it. Idiot. Kobe hides the tiger in his tool shed, and since these bullies have absolutely nothing else to do on a Saturday, they spy on him again and decide that they want the tiger.
I want that tiger.
I want that bear.
Luna scares them away after some annoying slapstick, and Buster leads Billy and his parents over to Kobe's house. Why? Because the director couldn't think of any other way for the parents to find out about the tiger. Yeah, the dog somehow knows that Luna's in trouble, and he somehow feels the need to go save her when she's only caused him nothing but trouble. What are you trying to be about, movie? Do you want to be about the tiger and the kid? The tiger and her mom? The tiger and the dog? Pick a relationship to develop and stick with it! So Billy confesses to the whole thing, and his parents get a chance to bond with Luna as they clean her up before taking her back to Safari World. And sadly, putting this feral cat into a bubble bath does not result in her slashing all these idiots into pepperoni. Christopher Judge shows up to collect Luna, and of course he's just happy to have her back.
And Billy, I want to thank you for taking such good care of my little runaway. My little Luna.
Yeah, I'm really gonna miss her.
You know, I remember the first time I ever saw a tiger. I must have dreamed of hundreds of adventures. In fact, I even wrote down some of the better tales.
And this is the one that they decided to turn into a movie. This is the worst day of my life. So Christopher Judge asks Billy if there is anything that he can do to repay him for taking care of Luna. And what does he ask for? He asks him to bring the mother tiger to meet the bullies at the park, where she could easily escape and cause all kinds of murder and mayhem. Why isn't anyone making a documentary about these idiots? Coming soon from the producers of Blackfish. Oh my god, these people just took a tiger out in public to scare a couple of kids. Why isn't anyone calling the cops? Oh, by the way, remember that shot of the dad singing before and you thought that maybe he was just dropped on his head as a child? Only now, at the end of the movie, are they explaining that he works in advertising, and he was trying to think of an ad campaign for a new kind of cleaning detergent. Screenwriting at its finest, folks.
There's a client that I've been working with, an advertising campaign for them, and nothing has worked. Forever, really. Ever. And today I met with them, and they absolutely love this concept.
That's Luna.
Yes, that's Luna. They love Luna. They want to make Luna the spokesperson for the brand.
One, why would you call a cleaning detergent spot on? Aren't you trying to get the spots off? Two, if your cleaning product must be called spot on, why are you associating it with an animal that doesn't have spots? And in the midst of this creative frenzy that we never saw, it seems like dear old dad has come up with a book cover for Christopher Judge's Tiger Tales. And the main character is white instead of black. I'm sure he'll just love that. But we're not done yet. It turns out that he's so happy to have Luna back that he just gives away 6 lifetime passes to Billy and Kobe. Yeah, you're allowed to be thankful for Luna's return, but if closing your gates for a day is enough to cause the kind of financial turmoil that it has been, I don't think you're in a good position to be throwing away tickets like this.
Who wants to go to Safari World? With me.
I do. Thanks, Kobe. You're awesome.
Because if you can't win girls over with charm or good looks, just win them over with bribery. This movie is terrible.
And there you have it. Our story ends where it began. A happy ending for one and all. Carla is very happy to be reunited with Luna. And Billy and Kobe got what they wanted and are now considered kind of cool because of their new feline friends. and girlfriends. Oh, who am I, you ask? Well, I'm the lucky guy who published Joe Camp's comic book, A Tiger's Tale, based on this story. And it became such a bestseller that we're developing A Tiger's Tale 2 right now. So I guess you could say I'm the happiest one of all.
And at the end of the day, isn't the happiness of someone who had nothing to do with this story the only thing that really matters? I don't care. I'm just happy it's over! The story is full of cliches and contrivances. Every character is stupid beyond comprehension. The actors are annoying. The dialogue is painful to endure. The editing is as bad as an Ed Wood movie. And while I'm sure that no animals were harmed in the making of this picture, you just know that the tiger cub is going to be scarred for life after this experience. So in conclusion, if you want to give your kids a story about a young boy and his tiger, just give them the Calvin and Hobbes book. See you later.
Adorable ones. Now, look at me. I'm this short, fat, insecure, middle-aged thing.
I made you short?
Subscribe. Like. Follow. Comment. Watch more. More.